Sometimes you wanna go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You wanna be where you can see, our troubles are all the same. You wanna be where everybody knows your name. Hello guys, and welcome back to the channel.
What is this?
I just got finished watching the Suicide Squad. Whew, that was intense. We've got quite a lot of stuff to talk about. So welcome to my partially non-spoiler, partially spoiler, I'll say when we're at spoiler sections, review. We got a lot to go through, so let's just jump right in. And these are sort of just like my initial impressions. And then things that I kind of just wanted to briefly talk about. So yeah, let's get into it. Okay, so to keep things simple, I'll kind of just start with like one thing that I thought was like the best part of the movie, and then one thing that was kind of like irking me the most. That way, if you want to get like the meat of the video, you don't have to stay a super long time, and then at the end we'll have some more smaller but definitely important things that you can stick around for if you'd like. I loved the stylistic elements. That was my favorite part of the movie. I feel like with a superhero team like the Suicide Squad, you can't really have like a normal movie or even like a normal superhero movie, which is kind of like what the 2016 film tried to do. Here's the introduction of our characters. Here's the introduction of a conflict. Okay, here's like the mid battle. Here's the final battle. And I know I'm like skipping a couple steps, dumbing down the terms. That's for me, honestly. But that's kind of what the 2016 movie tried to do, and you can't really do that with a group like the Suicide Squad. This movie, though, they tried to sort of experiment with the way the plot was told, kind of the way the storyline was spread out, and I appreciated that, honestly. I liked that. I'm gonna call it Tarantino-ing. Obviously, I know Tarantino isn't the only person that does this, but Pulp Fiction is just such a perfect example, such a famous example. A couple examples of this would be, like, some scenes with Harley Quinn had some, like, a lot of stylistic... I know I say that word a lot, but it's hard to describe, especially without giving away too many spoilers. So we're just going to go with stylistic elements that were very fun, like visually appealing, very colorful movie in contrast to 2016, which was also pretty colorful, but it's kind of like when you compare, and I am going to be coming back to Guardians, Guardians 1 to Guardians 2, like when you're in, whenever Guardians 1 came out, was that 2014, looking at it, you're like, wow, this is so colorful. That's the same thing for Suicide Squad 2016. And then you come to Suicide Squad 2 in 2021, or Guardians 2 in, I think, 2017, and it's like, wow, the other one looks like it's depression. You also had a lot of the title cards were very visually appealing, very fun to look at as well. I know I just used that term, but that's really the best way to describe it. There was one scene where we're getting some backstory on a particular character, and instead of just getting, you know, like a flashback, which we do get some tastes of later, some stuff that kind of contrasts with these nice stylistic elements that we're seeing, but I'll touch on that later. Instead of just getting a flashback, they kind of like present it in an interesting way, which is just awesome. My least favorite part of the movie, though, definitely had to be the tonal inconsistencies. This movie will go from a funny scene to a dramatic one and vice versa, like that. Faster than freaking King Shark can eat someone. That's another thing to talk about, dude, the gore. Oh my gosh. A lot of the scenes that are supposed to make you laugh, make you laugh. There are a couple that don't land, and there are some that I feel like could be more funny than they are simply because they feel out of place. But for the most part, the funny scenes are funny. And the dramatic scenes, they do make you feel something for the character, which is impressive, because for the most part, for most of these characters, you've only known them for like an hour. A lot of the action scenes, while bloody and CGI heavy, are impressive. But it's just, when you're switching between them so quickly, it's hard for someone's emotions to keep up. Take a look at a movie like Guardians Volume 2. I personally like the example of the scene where they're like jumping around in that spaceship a ton. It's funny. But then you have a more serious conversation between Yondu and Rocket where he's like, ah, I know who you are because I am you. That actually might not be the best example because it doesn't take very long time from the jumping around in space section to the serious conversation. But it feels like a natural transition. You can also take an example of the actual conversation between Ego and Peter, where he's like, you shouldn't have killed my mom and squished my Walkman. Like, that is appropriate. It fits. It feels, you know, relevant. Whereas some of the jokes in this movie will kind of just come out of nowhere, and they feel like they're just for comedy's sake. And sometimes it's like, hey, can we have a second to have a dramatic moment? I hope that makes sense. Okay, now that we've done my biggest yay and my biggest nay, we are going to get a little more spoilery. Still nothing direct, nothing like too direct, but if you really want to play it safe, then I would skip to this time to see my final rating. My final rating of this movie is probably like a 7 out of 10, but I'll explain myself more at this time. So check it out if you'd like. If not, thanks for watching. Okay, and we're back. Like I said, spoilers, so be careful. Kind of. So something about the movie kind of feels like half buttocksed. And it's not the fault of the movie, it's just the concept. From a filmmaking perspective, it's hard to make a good superhero movie, because a lot of the things that are going to make it a good movie, like the stylistic elements, if you're choosing to use that as your vessel, will often clash with the necessities of a superhero movie, like the characters who are going to be super extravagant, and the action, and in this instance, a superhero movie, such as Suicide Squad, and a lot of superhero movies will often need comedy. So then you have instances throughout this film where it feels like the stylistic elements are either pushed aside or take center stage in place of things that, like, you know, character development and action and even moments of drama, which in and of itself is a problem, because now you have audience that's trying to relate to characters that, because of how you advertise the film, the title of the film, and, you know, the concept Suicide Squad, plus the rating, they're not even going to be able to connect to. They don't even know how long this character is going to be alive. When you have a movie that is trying to be so unlike other films in the genre, where they don't want you sitting comfortably thinking that your heroes are always going to win or even survive, it becomes hard to be invested in them. What's the point of getting to know them if in an hour and a half, they're going to be split in half? That was a horrible joke. It sounded good in my head. It was delivered terribly. And that's another thing, man, is the gore. It is so hard to watch. And this is coming from a Mortal Kombat player. It's like they saw the helicopter scene from Deadpool 2, and they're like, yeah, let's just do that in the entire time. It's one thing to have video game characters, no matter how good the graphics are, getting mutilated. That's bad enough. But to have it be, like, real people, and especially with how, like, pretty good the special effects are, it's tough to watch, man. Like personally, I get scarred from that stuff. So far, though, I have been talking a lot of trash. I will say, if there's one thing about this style of, like, oh, you don't know if your characters are going to make it, it does make the final battle a lot more interesting, as opposed to something where, you know, okay, yeah, our hero's going to win. I want you to close your eyes for a minute and think back to when you first saw the Avengers. We hadn't had a decade of superhero movies up to this point, right? You saw these heroes, some of them just ordinary people, face to face with all these aliens and aliens and aliens, and it just felt impossible. Like the odds were stacked against you. It took your breath away, in a sense. You get a taste of that in this movie. You feel it, because you're not sure what's gonna happen. And that is a magical thing. So I will give props to Suicide Squad 2021 for that. So ultimately, as I was saying earlier, I do think I'd give this movie a 7 out of 10. It's just hard with the clashing of, you know, good filmmaking and superhero filmmaking and the clash between, like, drama and comedy. It's almost like an identity crisis at times. That being said, I respect it for trying to step out of the box. It's definitely a memorable supervillain movie, and definitely at times an extremely enjoyable one. So definitely check it out if you want. I do think I'm going to make more movies, more videos on this movie in the future on the channel very soon, because I feel like there's, like, more I want to say about it that I haven't been able to quite yet. So stay tuned. Hope you enjoyed. Like I said, check it out if you can, and thanks for watching.